Shalom one, Asherada. I want to give infinite honors to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushua, Bahashem, and Kakadash. I want to give double honors to our teachers, the apostles, the great millstone, and salutation to my fellow laborers in Yahushua, pushing his truth across the four winds, making their calling and election sure in these last days, seconds, and times. And I'm going to just break down the scripture. This is an edifying chapter. You know, Lord willing, is edifying to the hearer. It's a beautiful chapter. All right? I'm going to jump straight into it. Psalms 30. A psalm and a song at the dedication of the house of Yahweh. All right? And the dedication to the house of Yahweh is the leg men, man. The house of Yahweh Bashim Abashai is the 144,000 men, 12,000 from each tribe, including all of the one-third. All right, the 144,000 is the elite. All right, you have an elect within the elect, okay? And that's the dedication of the house of Yahweh by Shema Bashai, all right? Okay? You got to be spiritual. I will extol thee, O Yahweh, for thou hast lifted me up. And how did the Most High lift us up? He gave us this truth, okay? Yahweh by Shema Bashai pulled us out of this dark, perverse world into his marvelous life and gave us this glorious gospel, all right? And it woke us up out of our spiritual comatose dead estate, okay? And has not made my foes to rejoice over us. And he didn't let our enemies rejoice over us, all right? We stick to these prophecies, man, okay? And our enemies are going to be the glory of our salvation. They're going to behold us getting beamed up into those chariots. All right. They're going to behold us getting those glorified bodies, man. All right. They're going to say, are these the ones we had sometimes in derision? All right. And that's beautiful, man, that the Most High is going to make our table in the presence of our enemies, man. Okay. Oh, Yahweh, my power. I cried unto thee, and thou hast healed me, all right? And the elect pray to Yahweh by Shema Shai without ceasing, all right? Every brother have his different trial and tribulation he has to go through, and all we do is cry and pray to Yahweh by Shema Shai. We sigh and cry for the abominations going on round about us, and we pray that he heals us. We pray that he delivers us. We pray that he hear our supplication, and he ultimately does every time. Oh, Yahweh, thou hast bought up my soul from the grave, all right? And the grave represents slavery, man. The grave represents being in these chains of darkness, okay? Yahweh Bashem Abashai is going to free us. That's why he gave us this glorious gospel. John 8:32, you shall know the truth. The truth shall set you free from these chains of darkness and from the oppression of man, all right? Chiefly, the oppression of the nation of Edom, all right, to anti-Mashiach. Thou hast kept me alive. And John 6:63 say, his word quickeneth. That's what is keeping us alive, all right? That's what's keeping us out of this comatose state, all right? That I should not go down to the pit, all right? And what does the pit represent? The lake of fire, all right? These chains of darkness, being in a lower state, okay? Sing unto Yahweh, all ye saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holy. And what are we singing? We sing in this song that only the 144,000 men knew, all right? We sing in this glorious gospel, man, all right? And there's only a small remnant of the nation of Israel that understand those lyrics. Verse 5, for his anger endureth but a moment. This is only but a light affliction, although it seems like this is the worst and the lowest hell we in. All right. We lost our nationality. We don't have control of our family. Deuteronomy 28:15-68 has cleaved to us. This is a light affliction compared to what he has in store for us. And his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. The morning represents having his truth. All right. We are people of the day. All right. Light represents the truth. And in my prosperity, I said, I shall never be moved. All right. What does Philippians 4:13 say? I can do all things through Yahweh Shai who strengthens me. All right. If we have the faith to the mustard seed, we could tell it to that mountain, go ye yonder into the sea, man. Okay. So we have Yahweh by Shema Rasha. When we have this truth, we know that's not us in our prosperity. We know we should never be moved. All right. Yahweh, by thy favor, thou hast made my mountain to stand strong. All right. That's talking about the nation of Yasharala. All right, that's the house of David. We're closing up the breaches. All right, and Jerusalem is becoming the object of perfection again. All right, it's waxing strong and strong. The house of David is waxing stronger and stronger. Thou did hide thy face, and I was troubled. And the nation of Israel was troubled for a season. Now we're waking back up, and we're coming back into our beautiful form. But when he hid his face from us, hey, you see where we've been? We've been in this low as hell. I cried to Yahweh. And Yahweh, I made my supplication. And that's what we do daily. What profit there in my blood when I go down to the pit? Shall dust praise thee? Shall it declare thy truth? All right. So that's why you have to push this doctrine with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. What did Paul say? Woe is me if I preach not the gospel. Okay. What good of us if we're giving up the ghost, all right, and die a dishonorable death? So while long as you have oxygen waxing strong through your lungs, man, you got to push this truth, okay? Verse 10, hear, O Yahweh, and have mercy upon me. Yahweh, be thou my helper, okay? And we need Yahweh by Shema Rashad more than ever. That's why you got to be built up on your most holy faith so you can get through Jacob's trouble. That's why it's imperative you seek Yahweh by Shema Rasha'im while he may be found. Yahweh has turned for me my mourning into dancing. Yahweh has put off my sackcloth and girded me with gladness to the end that they may glory and sing praises to thee and not be silent. O Yahweh, my power, I will give thanks unto thee forever. All right. And that's a beautiful chapter, man. It gets your spirit up. All right. It's something to read before when you wake up from your sleep, and it rejuvenates your spirit, man. So it's a beautiful chapter. So with that, Lord willing, this beautiful chapter was edifying to the hearer. So I want to give infinite honors to Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh Shah, by Hashem, Rekar Kadash. I want to give double honors to our teachers, the pastors, the great millstone, and salutation to my fellow labors in Yahweh Shah. Kwam Yasharala, Abba, Abba.